Well, I've heard a lot about your desk.
It's a door with 4x4s.
Come on.
What?
I mean, you can afford a better desk than that.
It's a symbol of spending money on things that matter to customers and not spending money on things that don't.
And you don't need clean carpets.
What are these things on the floor?
Well, these are you know, sticky balls.
They're obviously they work.
Yeah, that's great. That's very impressive.
Remember, this man is a titan of our time, a giant.
What kind of kid were you?
Well, I was a good student. I always worked really hard. I was nerdy.
You were nerdy.
I was nerdy. That hasn't changed, by the way.
did you realize it back then?
My watch updates itself from the atomic clock 36 times a day, if that gives you any indication.
Really?
I'm afraid so.
But you did really well, huh?
In school?
Yeah,
I was always a good student.
Socially?
Socially, I was a little awkward, I think would be one way to put it.
Blind dates?
I didn't really date much until like my last year of college.
Which was where?
Which was at Princeton. Uh-huh. Actually, I set up sort of a formal plan to date. I had all my friends set me up on blind dates. None of them worked out very well.
Maybe it was his intensity, or maybe it was the way he talks. Listen to the way he describes his company's business plan.
We believe that this is a critical category formation time.
Bezos uses the same kind of Wall Street wonk talk when he talks or thinks about almost anything, including what he wants out of life.
The way I made the decision to leave Wall Street and do this was, you know, it'll sound geeky to you, but it was a regret minimization framework. So this is how I actually made the decision.
If I understand it, if I can translate that into English, I can deal with. Does that mean I want to live my life so that in a few decades from now, I'm not going to regret it?
That's exactly right. I want to have lived my life in such a way that when I'm 80 years old, I've minimized the number of regrets that I have. And I think actually a lot of people do that. I think they, even if they don't, you know, call it something as dorky as regret minimization framework, they behave that way anyway. They think that way. And
but for you, it was not carpe diem. It was not wine, women, and song.
No. I don't go in for carpe diem. I go in for regret minimization framework. Absolutely.
If you want to see another awesome young Jeff Bezos video, check it out right there next to me. I think you'll enjoy it. Continue to believe. I'll see you there.